Hello everybody, Bud Brown here. I'm making this video as a response to a question that I had. A young lady asked me why there's a certain word in this sentence in Tagalog, and the sentence is ano no gagawin ng tao ito. Gagawin ng tao ito. And it means the people will do this. The people will do this. Well, to break this down, this is the future tense of gawin, to do something. Remember, you repeat the first syllable, gagawin. And by the way, if you've read the comments, not all verbs, you just repeat the first syllable. For example, ligo means to take a shower, but the future of ligo is maliligo. Maliligo ako. I'm going to take a shower. But anyway, the point of this lesson is she was wondering, what does that nang hear? It's ng, but it's pronounced nang. And tao means people. Ito means this one. So I'm going to try to explain why nang tao instead of just tao by itself. In Tagalog, there are certain words, I call them possessive words, but they're not always used. I call it the possessive form, but they're not always used like a possessive. Now, if you're not sure what possessive means, that means you have something, like in English, my car, his car, her car, those words, my, your, his, their car, those words are possessive pronouns. Now, if it's not a possessive pronoun, like the word man, you would say the man's car or the boy's car, like that. Well, in Tagalog, these possessive words are ko, meaning my. You would say pangalan ko, I, Bud Brown. Name, my, is Bud Brown, or my name. Mo is for you. Nya could be he or she. Pangalan niya, si Mary. Pangalan niya, si Jojo. So, nya can mean him or her. There's no differentiation in Tagalog. And also, for them, nila. Now, here's where this relates to that question of nang tao. And by the way, here, spelled nang, but pronounced nang. If it's an object other than the person, his, her, my, your, for example, the boy, the girl, the man, the woman, you would use nang in front of it. Like if I want to say that is the man's car, ito ang kotse ng lalaki. So nang means like of the man. In this case, it's talking about the people are doing it, nang tao. So even though you're not saying the verb of the person, when you use verbs, you would use nang after the verb to say who's the subject, who did it. So I'm trying to think of a good example. In this, no, not this one. This one, the original sentence. Gagawan ng tao ito. So this means the people will do this. If I wanted to say the man will do this, I would say gagawan ng lalaki ito. The woman will do this. Gagawin ng babae ito. So, you can say, he will do, she will do, they will do, I will do. Gagawin ko ito. Gagawin mo ito. Gagawin niya ito. Gagawin nila ito. Or, gagawin ng babae ito. Or gagawin ng some person or something. So, it seems like a complicated explanation, and I guess I should have put a disclaimer at the beginning of this video that Tagalog is not my first language, it's not my second language, it's not my third language. I'm definitely not an expert, and I haven't had formal classes in Tagalog. I've had, my only experience with Tagalog is from just being around Tagalog speakers. So this is the rules that I've tried to figure out. Okay, thank you, and till next time, bye-bye.